Hi, this is Tony Clark. I'm here tonight with IHSA state final official, Mike Herkus. Mike is also a IHSA wrestling clinician and rule interpreter. Our question for Mike tonight is, how does an official get themselves ready and prepared to work the IHSA wrestling postseason?
Thanks, Tony, for the invite. Boy, we get that question a lot, and there are a lot of things that you can do. And you need to be working at your craft. Obviously, you need to know the rules. You should be going to clinics every single year and going to workshops when they're in your area, and should always be learning the sport. You know, it's always changing, new rules, and you kind of, you know, need to stay abreast of that stuff. If you're not working varsity matches, you're not getting assigned there, as the underlevel, you need to be staying and helping with the varsity, asking to assist, maybe asking to whistle if you know the head official. He can check with the coaches. Maybe you can alternate, maybe you can take a few matches, and you need to help yourself be seen by these people. And when you're out there, they'll realize that you're working at this craft, and that head official, that lead official that is working with you, if you're doing a good job, he now can promote you to a sign or say, hey, I just worked with referee X. He did a real good job. He's looking to get some higher caliber duels or maybe varsity duels. And that's one way. Just be seen as an assistant, be seen as an underlevel, and stay and help and work that varsity match. You also need to be thinking about how available am I to ref? Am I staying in my little area, my zip code, or am I expanding myself and being seen by other coaches? How often am I reffing? Am I reffing 1 day a week, 2 days a week? A lot depends on your schedule, but the more you can make yourself available, that will help. You'll be seen by more people. And quite frankly, you know, what is the caliber of the matches you're taking? You know, a signer can't just take somebody that they've never seen work or know nothing about and put him into a hotbed of a varsity duel. There is a growing process, and you know, we normally start off at that under level and we work to that varsity level. And once you get to that varsity level, then you're going to start to get ratings. And with those ratings, you know, it's okay, you know, at the end of a match to say, coach, just a reminder, if you could please, you know, rate me next week or rate me when you get a minute, that would be awesome. You can send an email, a few days later. Coach, I worked your match last Friday. You know, great job, congratulations. Or, hey, it was a great match. Your kids wrestled well. And if you could please put your ratings in, that would be helpful. And any feedback that they have for you. Another great thing to do for to get a lot of exposure for ratings is tournaments. And a lot of tournaments are hard to get into. You have some senior level officials that might be working a particular tournament for 15, 20 years. And, you know, maybe you're interested in getting to that type of caliber. You know, you need to talk to assigners, but you need to talk to coaches that are actually hosting those. And, you know, if a coach at a school that's maybe nearby or far, you know, hey, I really want to work your tournament. What do I need to do to work your tournament? You know, you need to get yourself available and let other people see you doing a good job, and that opens a door for you. But your ratings, you know, they are the ticket to helping you get to that next level. You know, if you're not doing varsity matches, you're not getting the ratings. And as that, like I said earlier, as a under-level official, if you're doing the fresh offer or JV level, if you go to that varsity match and you assist at the varsity level or you alternate whistles, those coaches can now rate you. And it's okay to, you know, talk about that and say, hey, I'd love your ratings. If you can do that, that'd be great. But you need to work at getting as many ratings as you can. I just haven't made a brain cramp. We'll have to edit right there.
Okay, well, I got another question for you.
Okay.
A lot of people don't realize you were an outstanding coach in your day. So put on your coach's hat. What would Mike Herkus, the coach, look for in an official? What are the qualities you would be looking at?
Well, I was fortunate to have very good officials come to our school when I was coaching here. I always wanted to see an official that was working hard at it. They cared about the wrestlers. They were into the match. They were hustling. I realized that they were going to miss calls. I mean, it's just nobody's perfect. You can't see everything. But if they're working hard at it, you know, I could always excuse it. I might not like it, but I could excuse it. And quite frankly, they had to be approachable. They had to at least let me talk to them at the table, or, you know, it's an emotional sport. You know, I tried never to cross the bounds of being, you know, unsportsmanlike or inappropriate, but it's emotional, and I wanted them to listen and not be combative, and then I tried not to be combative. It was a respectful thing. But I, you know, and obviously they got to know the rules and they got to do a good job. And I really appreciated it especially when they were younger officials, if they said to me, hey, you know, any feedback that you have for me at the end of a match, that'd be great. That means they're open and they're being reflective and they are learning. And I've seen a lot of officials new to the sport come in and they think they've got it and they're not very reflective and they are not very receptive of constructive criticism. And boy, if you're going to be reffing in the sport, you're going to get some criticism, and you know, hopefully you can take it and learn from it and grow from it. That's what I kind of look for. And when they make all the calls go my way.
Well, everybody wants to get the official on their side one way or the other. Just from your own perspective, how have you seen the officiating world change, let's say in the last 5 years? What have you noticed? And, you know, what are your thoughts there?
Well, boy, our sport, the athletes are great. You know, I'm in the suburbs. There's a lot of, you know, we hear this in the NFL. They're bigger, stronger, faster, and it's trickled down to the high school level. They are quicker. The wrestling is quicker. They're more powerful. They're more explosive. And you need to be on your toes, and you need to be able to move with that action. But there's also a lot of scrutiny in the officiating world. You know, everybody's got a camera, everybody's got a cell phone, and, you know, we're out there trying to do the best we can, trying to put ourselves in the best position we can. And you know, you make a call, we've heard this before, you know, sometimes 50% of them like it, 50% don't. And then everybody has a camera, and they're trying to pinpoint, well, was he actually correct or not? And sometimes you are and sometimes you're not. Hopefully you're correct more than you're wrong, but that is part of the gig. But it's a great gig, but it is changing.
How do you feel about the decline in the number of overall officials? Do you think it's hurting our quality? Do you think it's just, you know, what do you feel is causing that problem?
Oh, it's a number of things. It's a number of things. It's a tough sport. It's really tough to officiate any sport, but wrestling is physically demanding. Not saying the other sports are not, but you know, if you're on your feet for 8 hours at a tournament, that's pretty physical. But the emotion and the passion and the expectation that coaches are experiencing, because they're putting all this time and effort into their kids and they want the best officiated match they can get. And we are human and sometimes we make mistakes. And so sometimes, you know, it can get heated and some people aren't good with that. And the decline is there and it's real. And I've been doing it over 20 years now. And when I first got into the sport, I kind of heard, yeah, we're on the decline. And that really wasn't overly necessarily true. But now, in the position I am now, and I do see those numbers and they're tremendously low, and we've lost the ability to get new people in and retain them, and we're trying very hard to do that, and I think it's to be resolved. Everybody's got to get on board. That means our fan bases, our officials, and our coaches. They have to recognize that we all need to work together to help our young, inexperienced officials, help them grow, you know, teach them when they make mistakes, give them suggestions, and it really needs to be an effort from everybody. That we need to recruit our new officials from our leaving seniors that are going away to college or joining the workforce, try to get them back into officiating, you know, bring them along, bring them into your wrestling rooms. Coaches can bring them into their wrestling rooms, and we need to really try to teach more than we need to yell and scream and have these unbelievable expectations, especially for our new officials. We need to do a better job of teaching and molding than screaming and running them away.
Well, Mike, thanks for your insight. Hopefully a lot of our listeners will find it to be helpful. Any parting shots you want to throw out there?
Well, I'm looking forward to a great year. We've got some new rules that will make refereeing a little bit more challenging, but I think without a bounds and near fall, but I think it's a great rule, and sure we'll have a few little hiccups here and there in the beginning of the season, very similar to last year with the arm trap lift, but I think by Christmas everybody will have a good understanding, and I think by the time we get to the state series it'll be a great tournament again, so looking forward to it.
All right, thanks again, Mike. Thanks for your time.
Thank you.